big priority for you as mayor. In fact, you've said your number one priority was crime. You said this: we will live or drive by public safety.
Yes.
And you've made a lot of progress. Violent crime has come down considerably. I understand March was the first murder-free month in 44 years in Newark. On the other hand, I've also understood that total homicides are a little up this year.
Compared to last year,
compared
yes.
to last year, which was down from previous
yes.
years, I realize. Okay, you've had 4 years of this. What has worked and what has not?
Well, look, the management is actually, you know, pretty much the same, whatever you're taking on. And if you walked into our police department, whether you're a criminologist or not, you could have immediately seen problems. Our police departments look like scenes from a sitcom like Barney Miller in many ways, because guys were working on typewriters, buildings were old and decaying. We weren't affording these great police officers the pride of place, places stenching with urine and other problems. And so we had to immediately confront a lot of these things. We had nonsensical things like, detectives and gang task force by union agreements were working Monday through Friday, 9 to 5. Well, you know, gangs don't work Monday through Friday, 9 to 5, at least not in our city, maybe here in New York on Midtown, maybe they do. But we had to confront a lot of immediate issues. But then it's all about leadership, and that's what we're looking for in our school system. We found a great police director who had experience here in the New York system that came in and implemented a lot of strategies that were very effective. We had to create strategic public-private partnerships. We're a city that really leveraged private support in a dramatic way, whether it's in posting cameras, the most lucrative tip lines in the country, to really create even more change. And then community engagement, whether it's our clergy or in other ways. So we were able to pull a lot of alliances together. Then we look beyond the police department. There's a massive problem in America with taking human potential, warehousing it in prisons. And then when people come out of prison, that's one of our biggest source of criminals.
Because they get out and they come back.
65% go right back.
And then they go back
to prison. Right. So we have thousands of guys coming, men and women coming home every year from prison, and they find themselves more. I've come to realize, especially in the job as mayor, that most of us human beings are far more rational economic actors than we care to think about. And if you understand sort of the economic incentives of life, you can often empower people to succeed or to take on behaviors in many ways that are more community beneficial. So if you're a guy who comes out of prison, imagine if you and I came out of prison. We have thousands and thousands of dollars of child support arrears that have come up. An angry mother of our child who urgently needs help and support. You have parking tickets that are now have your driver's license suspended, so you can't even drive legally. You've got thousands of dollars on your driver's license. You can't even get your identification. It's so hard to go to DMV. You have immediate needs of food. Most human beings need food on a regular basis. I don't understand why. You have these challenges with housing. Now, get a job.
Try to apply for a job.
For a job, with all those sort of strikes against you. You yourself might not have attained high levels of education. You now have criminal conviction. In this economy, employers have choices. So that means that you are going to probably make a rational economic choice that I need to get back in the narcotics trade quickly so I can feed myself, I can feed my family, and so forth.
Well, and so you've done something that strikes me as quite innovative, which is started the office of reentry, is that
yes.
what it's called?
Well, we've decided, you know what, we're going to experiment and be entrepreneurial in a lot of areas. That's one of the things government often is not. It's often not a place where you see entrepreneurialism. And what we decided to do is pull together a lot of private actors, nonprofit actors, to say, let's come up with a lot of ideas. So we started the Office of Reentry in Newark in partnership with a right-leaning organization. This left-right coalitions are very important to me. So the Manhattan Institute became a very important partner of ours. We created in the first in the nation pro bono legal service project for ex-offenders, fueled by private law firms. And now when I get out of prison, if I have warrants out for my arrest, expungement opportunities, trouble getting driver's license. I can get a group of lawyers to work with me. We created the first fatherhood center in New Jersey where guys coming out of prison who were dads, we actually organized sort of a fraternity. We actually called it Delta Alpha, Delta Sigma Dads, to support our men in reducing their recidivism, but really connecting to their families, because the children most likely to go to prison in America are children of incarcerated adults. And we've now created programs, whether it's Office of Reentry, which has about a 10% recidivism rate compared to the 65% state and national average. Our fatherhood program has about a 3% recidivism rate. So we've created all these pockets of excellence now that are really working, and we're trying to show that this should be a policy shift in America to doing what more to empower people when they come home. And it'll actually drive down overall costs of government and create more economic energy in cities and states and nations, because suddenly you're unleashing the economic potential of large populations of Americans.